In this video, we are going to understand the basics of PDF automation. Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today, we are going to start a new series on this channel where we are going to focus on something which is called PDF automation, and this would be the first video in the playlist. My name is Mukesh Kala. I am now a 5x MVP certified solution architect and a LinkedIn top voice. I have shared my LinkedIn details on the page. Feel free to send a connection request. Happy to be part of your network. Also, you see a QR code on the screen, which is for the WhatsApp community. You can scan the QR and join the community to get the latest notification from the channel. Also, whenever you have some doubts, you can post in the group and the developers around the world try to help you. Having said that, let's get started. Okay, so this is the first video in the playlist, and my focus is to the beginners who have no idea about the PDF automation. So this video is going to be for the beginners who are just starting their PDF automation journey, right? So before starting that, let's see why do we actually want to automate PDF and why there is a need to automate the PDF. Okay, now if you talk about enterprises, if you talk about enterprise use cases, whenever we talk about invoices, receipts, report, contracts, most of the times all these files are coming into the form of PDFs. And since I am targeting the enterprise use cases, that means that we also want to do the automations. So now, since PDF is a critical part of enterprise processes, my automation should be also capable of doing the PDF automation. It should have capability to read, write, modify, edit, split, and a lot of other things would come when we actually talk about the PDF automation. If I try to do these things manually, it is definitely going to take more time. It is going to take a lot of human efforts. But if the same thing I am trying to do with the robot, it is going to improve the accuracy. It is going to make me more compliant. To give some examples, I have also taken some of the examples here, right? Such as extract payment details from invoices. You have an invoice which is having a lot of data, and from that invoice, I am interested to know who is the sender, who is the receiver, what is the total. I can also split and merge client reports. So let's say I have a report, and that report has, let's say, data for 5 different clients, and I want to split the data into 5 different clients. I have to use the PDF automation. I can also use PDF automation to autofill the onboarding forms. I can also use to extract the tabular information and a lot of other use cases, right? And all of this is possible with the help of UiPath PDF automation. Good part, it can work with both the text-based PDF and the scanned PDF. We'll talk about it when we move forward, but we need to understand that this is why we need to automate the PDF. Okay. Now, whenever we talk about PDFs, there are two kinds of PDF, and as a developer, before we develop, it is important for us to understand what is the difference and when to use what, right? Which type of automation basically. Okay, so on my screen you see there are two PDFs, right? This one is a text based PDF and this one is a scanned PDF. Now, what do I mean by that? So for the text-based PDF, if you see here, I am able to select the data from the PDF, meaning I can just right click on it, I can copy the text. This is a PDF which is a text-based PDF, meaning I'm able to select the data like this. However, if you have some PDF or some documents where you are not able to do the same operation, something like this, which is a scanned form of PDF or simply an image, then these kinds of the PDF are known as the scanned PDF, right? And this one are known as the text base. Why it is important? Because depending on the kind of PDF you would have, the same kind of activities you are going to utilize into the UiPath. Okay. So I believe now you understand what is the difference between text and the scanned one. Okay. So a quick differentiation, can copy paste the text? It is yes. Here you cannot do it. It is suitable for read PDF text, which is like, because it is text, so I can read it with the help of text. But this one is a scanned PDF, so that means that I cannot use the PDF text to read these kind of things, right? Do I need an OCR, optical character recognition, which is an engine inside UiPath to read the scanned or the images? In case of the scanned PDF, we would need an OCR, but in case of text, we do not need an OCR because we can directly read the native PDF. Accuracy wise, it would be always high because it is a text base. And here the scanned PDF, the accuracy would be medium or low compared to the text base because we are using an OCR engine, and depending on the capability of the OCR engine, we will get the output. And by the way, you can have different OCR engines available inside UiPath. We'll talk about that when we go to the OCR. Okay. Processing speed, as the name suggests, text base would be fast because you are directly reading the text. Here we are passing the image to an OCR engine and getting the data. That's why it would be slower. And if I talk about the activity, we are coming to that. That's where, wherever it is a text base, you are going to use the read PDF text. Wherever it is not text, you are going to use OCR. That's why it is called read PDF with OCR, right? So that's the basic difference between a text based PDF and the scan based PDF. Side by side comparison looks like this, where you are able to select the data, that would be a text base. We are not able to select the data, that would be your scanned PDF. Okay, so now with all this background about the PDFs and the PDF automation, now it's time for us to go back to UiPath Studio, create a solution and get start with the PDF automation. Okay, going back to my UiPath Studio now. Okay, so I am back to my UiPath Studio, and this I am using the community edition. So which means that you do not require an enterprise trial or any other subscription to work with the PDF activities. Okay, I'll just go here and I'll try to create a new process. I'll call this as PDF automation, right? And then I'll just put my channel name so that I can recognize it. And I would just say process for PDF automation, right? And I'll just go here and I'll say create, right? So that's going to create the PDF solution for me, PDF automation solution for me. And in the upcoming videos also, I would going to use the same solution, right? And this is the latest UiPath Studio. In case you are new and you are finding this interface a bit new, feel free to refer to the update video where I have tried to understand and make you comfortable with the new interface. Okay. Now, the first thing first, if you go to the project and I can just pin this, then just after the project, you have now the activities which are here. And now to do the PDF automation, if I just search here PDF, you would see a lot of activities which are inside the available PDF and all, right? However, the official dependencies to do the PDF automation is this one. So I'll go to the project, I'll go to the dependencies, right click on it, manage the dependencies, and then I'll go to the all packages, right? In case you are following this channel for a long time, right, you would understand that whenever I have to do a certain kind of automation, we add dependencies. Why do we add dependencies? To get those activities into my activities list, right? If you don't add those dependency, you won't be able to utilize them, right? You could have directly drag and drop the activities also, but I want to show it in a step-by-step manner. Okay, so first thing first, I'm going to go here and I'll just say uipath.pdf, uipath.pdf, right? And that is going to give you this activity pack, which is uipath.pdf.activities by UiPath, and I'm just going to install it and I'll save this, right? So what is happening in the background? All these UiPath dependencies is going to be loaded to this project, and now you would see that in the dependency I have the UiPath PDF activities. Okay, now if I go to the activities, there you would see that into the installed and inside app integration, you have now the PDF, and these are the activities which are available for us today to do the PDF automations, right? Which you can simply drag and drop and utilize into your project. Okay. Now, before I proceed with using one of the activity, I quickly want to tell you more about this package which we just imported, which as the developer is important for you guys, right? So please do focus. Okay, so the PDF activity pack contains activity designed to extract data from PDF and the XPS files. Remember, with the same activities, you can also automate the XPS file as well, and the output would be a string variable. Okay, now data can be extracted from the entire document. You can read the complete document or from specific ranges, page number 2 to 3, 5 to 7, all pages, you can do that. Now, if your project include UiPath document understanding.ml activities and the OCR activities or the PDF version, you must update the remaining packages as well. Now, why this point is important? In our one of the previous playlists where we have talked about document understanding, right? So document understanding is a technology to read data from documents. And when it comes to documents, obvious one is the PDF as well. So now, depending on which version of document understanding package you are using, you might also need to update your PDF activity package as well. So PDF activity package also depends on the document understanding or the intelligent OCR package if you are using. If you are not doing document understanding, you can skip this. But if you have in future, you plan to use the same project for document understanding, you might need to consider this as well. Okay. Let's go to the next one. For scanned documents, data extraction is achieved through OCR, which is with read PDF with OCR and read XPS with OCR. Whenever I have a PDF file, I'm going to use PDF, XPS going to use the XPS. Okay. Now, what about the OCR? OCR is of different type. We have AVI, we have UiPath OCR, we have OCR from Microsoft, we have OCR from Google. So, inside UiPath, you can have different OCRs engine. An OCR engine is available in the UiPath ecosystem, except for the screen OCR can be placed by into the body of the activity. This we are going to see, but the bottom line here is, as a developer, you need to understand that when I'm using OCR, I have an option to use any of the OCR. Okay. When using the UiPath PDF activity package with the intelligent OCR, ensure that you are having the version 2.x or 3.x. Again, intelligent OCR is for the document understanding. Okay. Both of this point relates to the document understanding, which is like UiPath intelligent OCR activity higher is not compatible with the PDF activities lower than 3.0, right? So in future, if you plan to incorporate this to the document understanding, you can utilize that as well. Okay. And the same thing goes here as well, right? So all these three points you should remember, because at the starting of the project, as a developer, you should know that what I want to do with this project. If you have idea of using, if you have plan of using document understanding intelligent OCR, you need to have all this in mind, right? And by the way, if you are absolute beginner to document understanding, have no idea where to get started, I have this full-fledged playlist where I am teaching you document understanding step by step by building a use case. You can download the files and practice along the same use case as well. Okay. With that, coming back to the topic, right? So this was all about the UiPath PDF activity package, right? Coming back to my UiPath studio now, and today, once we have this activity, we would have all of that. Let's try to drag and drop this activity, which is called read PDF text. Right, and the activity is very simple. You just have to provide the PDF, right? So I'll click on this browse button and I will select the text based PDF. I'll open this file and that will open the file path for me here, right? Right now I'm just showing it to here. In the upcoming videos, we are going to create some of the detailed use cases using these activities, right? Now the properties is available here. I'll leave everything to the default setting, and in the text, I'll just say Control plus K and I say str underscore text, right? Because the output of the PDF is a text, right? And then after that, I'll just maybe use a message box activity. And in the message box activity, I'll just print the text, right? I am doing nothing much, just reading the text based PDF, extracting the data and showing it into the message box, right? If I just go here and I say run the file, what I'm expecting is to UiPath to read this text file and give me the data into a message box, which is here. So basically, by just using one activity, I was able to read the complete data from PDF, right? So that was just a quick heads up on the PDF automation. In the upcoming videos, we are going to discuss more about these activities, what are the properties, how to utilize it, what are the different use cases you can cater with all these PDF activities, right? So this session was to just make you familiar with this and make your environment ready for the PDF automations, right? I have a quick assignment for you guys. So the assignment is very simple. You can just create any PDF, try to read the PDF, read the content and try to put it into the message box. If you are able to do that, maybe just comment down, read PDF successful, and I understand that people are following till this point, right? I'll wait for your comments and then see you in the next video where we are going to deep dive into the PDF automation in a step-by-step manner, right? So with that, wrapping this video here. Thank you for watching. If you like this content, make sure to subscribe to the channel and see you in the next one. Thank you for watching and happy automation.